Did you know that where you live, the food systems around you, your opportunities to be active, all of this has an impact on your risk of developing obesity? How big is this issue? How can you reduce your risk of developing obesity and protect yourself? And how would you know if you're living with obesity? Hello and welcome to Science in 5. I'm Vismita Gupta-Smith. We are talking to Dr. Francesco Branca today. Francesco, talk to us about obesity.
Obesity is a chronic disease defined by excess fat deposits that impair health. It can lead to type 2 diabetes, heart disease. It may affect bone health, reproduction. It is associated to certain cancers, and it affects the quality of living. And you get obesity because of the consumption of unhealthy diet, because of low physical activity, but also because of poor sleeping patterns and stressful life. Some people are genetically predisposed to obesity, and so it's easier for them to get obese, but also obesity can be the result of using certain medications. Many people live in environments that are conducive to obesity because of foods which are high energy, that are available around the clock, that are cheap.
So, Francesco, how big is this problem of obesity?
Obesity is a problem for health and for economic development. We calculate that 5 million deaths every year are caused by the consequences of obesity, and countries lose up to 3% of their gross domestic product because of obesity.
How would one know if they live with obesity, and how can they manage their condition?
To identify obesity, you would measure weight and height and calculate the body mass index. In adults, the body mass index higher than 30 kilogram per square meters helps the diagnosis of obesity. You can also measure waist circumference. In women, a waist circumference over 80 centimeters and in men over 90 centimeters indicates a high risk of the consequences of obesity. You will also see that with obesity, there's a high blood pressure. There are disorders of the blood lipids and of glycemic control. The response to this is that obesity is not your own responsibility. You shouldn't be ashamed if you're living with obesity. And people should not blame people living with obesity. Then the most important thing is to go to see a health practitioner who also should be professional and respectful for the people living with obesity, should help the diagnosis and should help with an integrated response, which is providing counseling on diet and physical activity, and as needed, suggesting drug treatment or even some surgical practices that would limit the consumption and the absorption of food.
What if I do not have access to healthy food or do not have access to or easy access to exercises? How can I prevent obesity and protect myself?
Community and national policies should help everybody to have access to healthy lifestyles. I would like to give some tips for everybody. If you're an adult, choose whole grains, fruit and vegetable, healthy fats, and limit sugars. Prefer water to any other drinks. Be active. If you're a mother of a young infant, breastfeed her or him as long as you can. Then for older children, give water and not sugar-sweetened beverages, fruit and vegetables instead of confectionery. Walk to school, limit screen time, and make sure that adequate sleep is given.
Thank you, Francesco. That was Science in 5 today. Until next time then, stay safe, stay healthy, and stick with science.